work of art is not to instruct, not to edify, but to awaken an emotion.
Montclair, as generously endowed by nature, may be enriched by art, and so rendered even more attractive as a select residential town.
Art is the product of the hand of man. We museum people simply make it available to everyone. We provide each person with the opportunity to allow it to become a deeply fulfilling element of daily life.
These are the voices of some of the founders and individuals whose hard work and devoted service over the past 90 years have built a nationally recognized center for the visual arts in northern New Jersey. The Montclair Art Museum, face to face with the American spirit.
A world-class art museum doesn't happen by accident. The Montclair Art Museum's genesis can be traced to the presence of a great American landscape artist, George Innes, who in the late 1800s chose this then rural community as his inspiration. A new gallery space is devoted entirely to the work of George Innes.
Innes was about that interconnectivity between all human beings and the other world. That is a primary reason why I am so happy to see this gallery, because it elevates those ideals. And it's that correspondence, the ability to express that correspondence, again, between all individuals, the material world, and the spiritual world, to be able to put that on canvas that makes this artist so special.
This Innes art consciousness filtered deeply into two individuals whose vision and generosity spawned the town's fledgling art museum. The first was Montclair collector William T. Evans, who in 1908 offered 36 paintings and a few sculptures to the town of Montclair if a fireproof building could be erected to house and protect them. In response, Florist Rand Lang contributed $50,000 toward the new building and offered a collection of Native American art collected by her mother, Annie Valentine Rand. From the museum's founding in 1914 to her passing in 1943, Mrs. Lang made the survival of the Montclair Art Museum her life's legacy.
Through the years, the community has rallied behind the many volunteers, board members, and staff who have shepherded the museum into maturity. For decades, the museum received no government funding, but membership grew steadily. Many individuals, corporations, and foundations recognized the value of this unique suburban institution and offered an ever-increasing level of support. Generous support from the New Jersey State Council on the Arts, since the creation of that agency, has been critically important to the museum's growth. The Montclair Art Museum decided early on to focus its collection on American and Native American art.
The earliest works in the Montclair Art Museum are late 18th century portraits. Here we see John Sinkelman Copley's portrait of Mrs. Stevenson, a great early American aristocratic lady. See her pearls, see her hands. Copley was 19 when he painted this painting.
It was fortunate to have many gifted eyes, such as those of director Catherine Gamble, for almost 40 years, building and refining a collection which by the end of the 20th century was called a model of the best that America's regional museums have to offer today.
Works of art are important manifestations of the creative spirit. They are works that embody and express with graphic force the deepest aspirations of a time and place, capturing its very essence. Things that are direct primary evidence for the study and understanding of mankind.
To support the creation of a public art collection in Montclair, the LeBrun Library opened in 1916 and is today one of New Jersey's main art reference libraries.
Education has been central to the Montclair Art Museum's mission since its founding. Three generations of children's lives have been touched by the museum's various educational programs. These programs include visits by school groups, outreach programs for students with disabilities, imagination station for children and parents, The Park Bench program even welcomes babies and toddlers. Studio art classes have long been central to the museum's offerings. Today, the Yard School of Art teaches adults and children in a broad range of visual media. Recognizing its need for growth, museum staff and volunteers began a campaign for a major expansion of the facility. Completed in 2002, the museum space has doubled, enabling new exhibit areas, new art studios, increased storage, new retail shop, and the Lear Hall, which hosts many museum and community-based events.
Today, as it kicks off a centennial decade leading to its 100th anniversary, the Montclair Art Museum has blossomed from what an early trustee called a local amenity into a cultural treasure serving northern New Jersey and beyond. Through its many exhibits and programs, the Montclair Art Museum thrives, ever challenging us to look deeply at the art made in this country, from the cultures of the many peoples who first inhabited our land to the many people who came here from every part of the globe.
Art museums are not formed in a day or even a decade.
So cautioned museum founder William Evans 90 years ago. Today, the founder's vision reminds us that a great art museum is both a legacy we receive from the past and one to pass on for future generations to enjoy. Now we ask you to join in our centennial decade. Help preserve this gem which shows us ourselves. The Montclair Art Museum. Face to face with the American spirit for decades to come.